This presentation is on minimizing soil compaction through coring. My name is Carl Danneberger and I am a professor of turfgrass science here at The Ohio State University. Soil compaction occurs when the percent soil solids and the water holding pores increase while the percent air pores decrease compared to an uncompacted soil. In this figure, the uncompacted soil on the left has more air pores compared to the compacted soil on the right. Compacted soils are poor growing mediums for turfgrass plants. Soil compaction is a serious problem on golf courses and athletic fields. On this soccer field in South Africa, the compacted soil has resulted in a decline in turf quality. An effect of soil compaction is also poor water infiltration, shown here by the ponding of water on the field. Additional detrimental effects of soil compaction include a decrease in root growth and activity, less stored plant energy in the form of carbohydrates due to an associated increase in respiration, increased plant temperatures, and increased susceptibility to environmental stresses. Coring is a mechanical means of relieving compaction by providing holes or channels to improve air movement into the soil. Coring relieves compaction, improves gas exchange, and helps reduce thatch. In the previous three pictures, the coring machines used 1/2 to 3/4 inch diameter hollow tines penetrating the soil to a depth of 2.5 to 3 inches. This is a schematic drawing of the impact of a hollow tine on turf. The second type of coring tine is the spoon, which is mounted on a rotating drum as shown here. Additional benefits to coring not previously mentioned include improved turfgrass growth around the core holes. Coring also penetrates and helps break up layering that may occur in the soil profile, shown here and here. Once cored, cores may be removed or reincorporated. Core removal can be done mechanically or by hand. Removing cores is often done in conjunction with top dressing. The amount of top dressing required is the amount needed to fill the holes. Cores can also be reincorporated back into the turf as shown here pictorially. Verticutting units are often used to chop up the cores and then drag back into the turf. Thus, the soil from plugs is reincorporated in the turf as a form of top dressing. Another version of traditional coring method is to use smaller diameter tines, 1/4 inch in diameter on closer spacing, called quadratining. Quadratining is often done during summer months to increase soil gas exchange with minimal disruption to the turf. There are a number of other types of small tines besides the hollow tines used in quadratining. For example, these solid tines are referred to as star tines. In some situations, coring beyond the 2.5 inch depth is desired. Drilling or deep tining are done for deeper soil penetration. This picture from the early 1960s shows a coring unit using tines that are drill type in nature. Deep drilling was initially done by hand, shown here with a drill and a long drill bit. The piece of plywood acted as a template for drilling. Mechanically, drilling devices are available. Drilling in combination of filling the holes with sand is popular. The term drill and fill is often used when drilling is done in conjunction with filling the holes with sand. Solid and hollow tine machines are also available that can punch holes deep into the profile. Finally, relieving soil compaction and promoting gas exchange is an important turfgrass management practice for maintaining the health of a turfgrass plant.